your gifts down. If you'd like to come over here, and I'd like you to reply to that vote of thanks. Let's gather.
That certainly was a surprise, I must say. Teachers, wow, you know, I think I'm really, I'm actually completely lost for words, because what I've seen and witnessed tonight is something that many, many years ago, I remember when I was in Zimbabwe, and having failed my first exam there, because I didn't know what word, manipulation of figures and words were. So I cried and cried, and it was a failure of the first exam that I ever had. But having seen you guys today with all the achievements, I don't think that I've achieved even half of what I wanted today. So congratulations to everyone, because this has really been, for me, a mind-blowing experience. I've learned a lot about you, actually, from my daughter Sabina. You may not know this, but I knew Stevie Howell very well. But she came and worked with me for a short time as a work experience student, and has done brilliantly well in Portuguese. I knew about Tyler, a football player, and Jonathan Leckie. So I've heard of some names, now it's nice to put some names and faces together. In congratulating you all today, I'm mindful of one thing, and that is that our success, your success, cannot be where it is today without the help of your teachers, your instructors, which means your academic prowess and your achievements in sports could not have been possible with the teachers and instructors that you've got, which actually is fantastic. The second thing is that your parents and carers have had a lot to do in your achievements today and will continue, I'm sure, to make sure that you go to achieve even better days. I wish to remember that the education that you have up today, for example, and continue to have over many years. This education will lead you to make a living, no doubt, through some sort of a career. But as to how you live is what the sum total of your experiences in life will bring you. It's always important to remember that that's something that I told my children many, many years ago, is that as we grow up, you should be big, bold, and brave. That, to me, is the recipe for success in life. And failures you will have, as I did myself. One of my first exams is that to you, I actually failed. I basically have three short messages. One is, you should be a lifelong learner. Now, continuing to learn throughout life and being curious about why things happen when you're a baby or as you're growing up, you want to know, why is the sky blue? Why do birds fly? That should continue throughout your life. So what will make you truly successful students? It won't necessarily be your brilliance or the arrogance that sometimes goes with it. It is the respect that you get from your peers and the respect that you give back to them. Appreciating when you're wrong and, more importantly, from time to time, knowing what not to do. Every single person in an organization that you work with as you go through your careers is important. It doesn't matter how big or how small. You have to remember that even a small screw in a jet engine, if that's missing, the whole jumbo jet comes out. Of course we will have differences, but this is healthy and expected. And in a democratic society, what we need to do is we need to debate and resolve our problems. It's also a second message for today. Have a passion about what you do. The enjoyment in the careers that you will have He's acting paranoid, David. But the fact that he's actually getting paid for that is, for me, a bonus. On your journeys, always look at how far you have come. Facing the past without regret, and handling the present with confidence, and with no fear of the future. In all this, sometimes, you must hurt in order to know, fall in order to grow, lose in order to gain. Most of life's experiences are learned through pain. Now, it turns to me today when I remember two teachers quite specifically who said to me, you are never going to make it. Well, I've proved them wrong three times. I've got a medical degree, doctor of philosophy, and doctor of science. So you guys can do even better. Remember, I got 14 A stars. If I had 7, I'd be lucky. The third thing really is, which is really some subject close to our heart, and that is about helping others, particularly as a charity. You are students of today and leaders of tomorrow. I think owing to people who have not had the excellent, clearly the education, excellent education that we've had, clearly, which has been manifested today. You should try and help other people who have not had this opportunity, help open doors for them, guide them with your time, give your time, give your energy, and occasionally even some money. For you to remember that most of the population in the world are actually poor. Such poverty creates disease, malnutrition, ignorance. But you have had the opportunity to get a fantastic education. So I hope that one or two of you, or many of you, will try and shine a light in those corners of the world where this world lives. Globally, you may know that every 4 seconds, one baby dies. Within the first 24 hours in the world, after birth, 1 million babies die. That should not be. As a pediatrician, I can just suggest that a little bit. But put together as people, through education, we can do a lot more. So finally, ladies and gentlemen, we must always count our blessings and pray for a healthy life for our families. And also, particularly, our parents and carers, who have looked after us throughout our lives and will continue to sacrifice to give us a better tomorrow. And then, Mr. Marshall, I am very, very impressed with what I've seen today, and I bring the greetings of Her Majesty the Queen as a deputy lieutenant. My daughter told me how fantastic this particular new group was. Now I witness it. I witness it firsthand. So, well done, guys and girls, and good luck.